Well, Maurice Flitcroft was a crane driver, 46-year-old crane driver from Barrow in Furness. He worked in a shipyard, and one day he got a colour TV and saw golf for the first time and just fell in love with the sport. And then, you know, after a short time, declared himself good enough to play in the British Open, which is always, I think it's almost like, I always think it's like the X Factor, you know, those people who sing in their rooms and go, I think I'm pretty good at this. And he, because he was very working class and from a place where the, he didn't know any golfers, he presumed that his standard was good enough to play in the British Open. He wasn't joking. He went for it, and he did very, very badly. But he didn't let it... didn't let it stop him, you know. He was determined to prove that he could do it and that he was good enough, and so he kept going. So it's a film about determination. It's about not giving up on your dreams, and it's about not sort of sitting with what cards are dealt to you. You know, it's like going, I want more out of life, and I think we all feel like that sometimes.
What's beautiful about the film is that Maurice is a figure of fun, but not ridicule.
Yeah.
And so much of that is because of Mark's performance. Can you talk a little bit about Mark's performance in the role and the essence of Maurice as a character?
Yeah, well, Mark was brilliant in that he took Maurice very seriously, you know, and it's why we were very lucky to get him, because he was serious in what he was doing. It was very important to me. I wouldn't have made the film if it was, or I wouldn't have written it or even been interested if he was just a joker and he was just taking the piss or he was, you know, just joking around. He wasn't. He was deadly serious, and he thought he was good enough, and he thought he could get there one day. And even when faced with the fact that he wasn't good enough, he still thought he could get there. So... Mark really got that. He got that, and he went for it. But having said that, he's got... No one ever knew deep down what was going on with Maurice, you know. And so now and again, you know, what Mark did was bring flashes of playfulness. And because Maurice was fun. He wasn't like, you know, he was also a sort of... someone who believed in dreams, you know, someone who was a dreamer. And so really, he took a very complicated character and made him real in a way that I hoped would happen, never thought would, but he did it.
Behind the camera, you had a relatively young storytelling ally in Craig. Can you talk about what makes him such a very special talent, and particularly as a director, what kind of a storyteller he is in that respect?
Craig just... I saw him in Submarine, obviously, and I thought, oh, yeah, that's that kid, he's like 15, isn't he? And then they went, oh, no, he's 30 now. And I went to see his film Eternal Beauty with Sally Hawkins, and I just loved his passion, his sort of playfulness. That film was actually about quite serious issues, but was still really funny. And was in unexpected ways, and it was very beautiful as well, very visually striking. I think he's amazing in that he doesn't compromise. Like, he's a young director who got this film's probably his biggest budget film, and he did things like he said it's got to be shot on real film, which nobody does these days. And then he went, if you don't, I'm not interested. And I was like, wow, who's this guy? He's got an encyclopedic knowledge of cinema. He's like a sort of Welsh Tarantino in that way. He probably won't like me saying that, or maybe he would. But he loves film. There isn't a film I've mentioned that he hasn't seen. And that's what I love about him.